Hallelujah. God is good. So what are your expectations this morning? I'm asking, whatever you are expecting this morning, just believe and agree, and it shall come to pass. And that's what this song is about. It's called We Agree. Hallelujah. Do you believe that this morning? Do you have an expectation this morning? Hallelujah. Hallelujah. These are the days of your decree. Hallelujah. And what you speak will be established once in the heaven, now in the earth. What you bind and what you loose is bound and loose in heaven. So we agree, we agree. Oh, we agree. We believe, we believe. The famine is gone. Come on, we believe, we believe. The fruit is on the vine. Speak it this morning.
How water is the latter end.
It's the latter end.
It's the latter end.
Hallelujah. We agree.
We agree.
These are the days when seasons change. Woo! Hallelujah. See, the first is last. And last is first. Oh, see, what you've lost shall be returned. The lost years recovered. Do you agree this morning? We agree. Oh, we agree. We agree. Dry places are watered. Do you believe that this morning? It's the latter end.
It's the latter end.
Yeah. So we believe. We believe. Yeah.
We believe.
Hallelujah. Do you believe that this morning?
Every single thing is possible.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. What are you believing for this one? What are you believing God for this one? Hey, all you got to do is give yourself. Give yourself whatever you have, whatever you need. Just give yourself this morning and agree. And all things are possible.
All things are possible.
Nothing is impossible.
Nothing is impossible.
All things are possible.
All things are possible.
Nothing is impossible.
Nothing is impossible.
All things are possible.
All things are possible.
Nothing is impossible. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Do you believe that this morning? Do you believe that this morning? Come on, there has to be a shout in this world. There has to be a shout in this world. There has to be a shout in this world.
Praise God. Now, this morning God has something very unique for us. But let me just set it up for us. During the weeks, Harriet, it's good to see you. Welcome. Praise God. I'm looking forward to your time to see you more often. She's blowing her eyes. Hey, listen, God is the God of all possibilities. Yes. Did you hear the song we just sang? Hallelujah. Praise God. But listen, this is a season when everything is possible. Don't even dare to think to put anything off the table. Are you hearing me? Praise God. Hallelujah. But let me just set this up. I said at some point, maybe on Friday night, there are four essential things about the kingdom of God. Four essential things. Number one, that you and I, as members of the kingdom of God, must acquire the language of the kingdom. And that language is Jesus. Now, if you are here on Friday night, you saw that so beautifully. When Pastor Susan got up and used the scripture in Judges chapter 10.
Amen.
Joshua chapter 10. With Joshua commanding the sun and the moon to stand still. Because he had an unfinished business. Now, this is the point. How in the world would Joshua have known that he carried the authority to speak to substance? How would he have known that? He only knew that because he, Joshua, came into the revelation of who Jesus is.
Yes.
Jesus is the one that told us, speak unto this mountain. Whatever your mountain is, Jesus is giving you the authority not to ask him to do it. He said, you, Shane, speak to your mountain.
Yes.
Bank, speak to your mountain.
Yes.
Greg, speak to your mountain. Hey. So Joshua tapped into who Jesus is, the language of God. And by tapping into the language of God, he knew what to speak out.
Yes.
So number one, essentially in the kingdom of God, Jesus is the fullness, the completion, the final revelation of God's thought, God's plan, God's word to mankind.
Amen.
Yes. And I told you, whether Isaiah said it, Jeremiah said it, Nehemiah said it, bring it to Jesus. And let Jesus interpret it for your today's consumption. Thank God for the promise keepers. They came up with this band and baseball caps that says, what will Jesus do? If they have this revelation, they will change that language.
That's right.
It's not a matter of what would Jesus do, past tense.
Yes.
It's a matter of what does Jesus do.
Amen.
Present tense.
Amen.
Or watch what Jesus does. Because when he said, what will he do, he puts Jesus in the past tense, as if he's no longer doing it.
Yeah. Yeah. Amen.
So first thing is acquire the language of the kingdom. The second thing we talked about is, you must also imbibe the culture of the kingdom, which is love.
Yes.
The third thing we talked about is, you must also operate in the system or process of the kingdom, which is faith.
Yes.
And the last one, which is what we're going to do just now, is that we must receive the attitude of the kingdom.
Mm.
Let's go to two scriptures. Philippians. Okay, let's go to 1 Thessalonians first. 1 Thessalonians chapter 5. 1 Thessalonians chapter 5. In verse 18. 1 Thessalonians 18. I mean 5:18. What does it say? It says, in everything, give thanks. For this is the will of God in Christ Jesus for you. And then in Philippians chapter 4, Philippians chapter 4 in verse 6, it says, be anxious for nothing, but in everything by prayer and supplication with thanksgiving, let your requests be made known to God. Wednesday we prayed, Thursday we prayed, Friday we prayed. We have high expectations of what God is doing and will do. Now, I think we need to base all of that with serious, involved, engaging thanksgiving.
Amen. Amen.
What are we thanking for? We are thanking him for the manifestation and the evidences.
Hallelujah.
Of all the prayers that have gone forward.
Yes. Yes.
And all the prayers that's going to be going forward. Are you hearing me?
Yes.
This is a serious, this is just as serious as the fasting. And it should not be just what we do when we're in church. The attitude of the kingdom of God is that of thanksgiving. So carry that with you. Begin to give thanks to God. You've asked. Remember the scripture? Ask and keep on asking. How do you keep on asking? Not necessarily by repeating the same prayers you prayed, but by giving thanks for the evidence and the manifestation of the prayer you believe God has answered.
Amen. Amen.
Huge. So, Brother Rotimi Awonaike and the rest of the group will lead us in a serious time of engaged, involved, serious, heaven-rending, earth-shaking, demon-chasing thanksgiving unto God for the evidences, I love that word, evidences of the manifestation of the blessings and the goodness of God unto the people of God. Are you ready for some evidence?
Yeah.
I said, are you ready for some evidence?
Yeah.
I said, are you ready for evidence?
Woo.
Give them to him the praise.
Jesus.
This I know. To him belong, they are weak, for he is strong. Somebody sing with me. Yes,
Jesus loves me.
Somebody declare it this morning, if you're
yes,
sure.
Yes, Jesus loves me.
God.
Somebody give him praise. Give him praise. Give him praise. Come on, give him praise. Give him praise. Give him praise. Give him praise. Hallelujah.
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 Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. What a mighty God will serve.
Hallelujah.
King of kings and Lord of lords.
Hallelujah.
Hell shall die.
Hallelujah.
The Lord who is more than enough for me. Everything that I've wanted, you've always provided. I have never wanted for nothing. There is nothing I need. You are always there for me. So I bless your name. So many words to describe you, Lord. So many words to describe your glory, describe your mercy, describe your majesty, describe who you are. Father God, I bow at your feet and I say, hey, you are my God, so we praise your holy name.
Hallelujah.
From the east to the west, from the north to the south, your glory covers it all. The sea obey you, the cloud obey you, the mountains, they stand still. The name of Jehovah, God would praise your name. Woo. Cause you're indescribable, uncontainable. You place the stars in the sky and you know them by name. Hey, you are amazing.
You are the king.
on, somebody. Worship him this morning. Let him hear your voice. Let him appreciate that you love him because he first loved you.
Can do that for me.
Born to you. Somebody sing it.
You have won the victory.
Hallelujah, hallelujah. Somebody come on, just worship him in your own words today. You don't need a song to bless your Father for all the good things he has done for you, setting you free from the curse of the law. Somebody, let him open your mouth and just bless him today. He's just arrested the procession of this worship, just so you can speak to him in your own words.
Woo! Lord, I praise you, Lord. Holy Lord. Worthy is your name, Lord.
Seated in majesty.
Yes.
Oh. My majesty, majesty. Your grace has found me just as I am, empty-handed, born alive in your hand. salvation.
You are the risen King.
Thank you for provision.
You are the risen King.
Thank you for protection.
You are the risen King.
Thank you for being my Father.
You are the risen King.
Thank you, Father.
You are the risen King. Yeah.
Thank you, Father.
You are the risen King.
Somebody just wave your hands and just bless him. This.
Hallelujah.
Oh my soul. Oh my soul. Worship holy name.
Worship the Holy Name.
Thank you, Lord. Amen. And so, Father, we thank you for a wonderful manifestation of your love towards us. We do not take these times for granted. We bless your name. We praise you. We magnify you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. As the sheep of your pasture, we've entered into your gates with thanksgiving. And into your courts with praise. We've magnified your name. We've blessed you. We've thanked you. And so, Father God, with eager and thank you, Father God, for your mighty habitation in our lives. We bless you and we praise you, Lord. In Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. If you just take your seat for a moment, we're about to receive communion and then go. But I just want to ask, was anybody touched in any unique way? I don't want to just leave. If anybody was touched in any unique way and you just want to share that with us in this very unique service, is there anyone that perhaps received something from God? God said something to you uniquely that's a blessing to you, that will be a blessing to your brothers and sisters for hearing it. Remember, Mary received a good word, visited Elizabeth, and in that confirmation, that destiny became contagious. Anyone? Praise God. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Amen. I don't want to put anybody on the spot. Yes, yes. Thank you. Praise God.
As we were worshiping God and the glory of God just filled the temple, and we've been talking about believing God, and what God brought to my remembrance were that at the pool, the man that was waiting for so many years was just waiting there, and he kept saying and waiting for the stirring of the pool, amen? But he had no belief. He didn't believe that he could be healed. But Jesus said, he would say that someone had to bring me to the pool. And I was just looking around and I was saying, the waters are stirred. Why is the altar not filled? Why are we still holding on to unbelief? We serve a radical God, and we have to let go and let God have his way. Amen. We can't put the brakes on God. We can't worry about what someone else says or what Jesus saying. Let's not go any further next year or next week or wait for the next manifestation. Receive it today. Receive it now. Receive it while the presence of God is here. Receive it. Receive it. Let loose those chains. Let those burdens be lifted in the name of Jesus. And receive joy. Receive peace in your home, in your marriage, in your family. And come and thank God for it. This is a time of thanksgiving. This is a time to say thank you, Jesus. I thank you, Lord God, for what you've done. I thank you, Lord God, for what you've already done. I thank you, Lord God, for the manifestation of that healing. I thank you, Father, in Jesus' name. This is for JoJo in Jesus' name. This is for JoJo in Jesus' name. This is for JoJo in Jesus' name.
Amen. Praise God. Did you have something about Lucky? Oh, okay. I just want to make sure. You have something?
Hallelujah. I just want to share this for about a minute or two and just go sit down.
Against the bricks, Acts chapter 10.
Bricks.
Acts chapter 10, I think. No. Acts, that's when Paul, that when Jesus was speaking to Paul. Acts chapter 8 or 9.
When you experience the reality of who God is, I don't believe your life can ever be the same again. I said, everything is good. When the word began to come, and I find myself latching onto the word. Now understand, I've been in the Lord for years. Thank you. see reality of it. Now let me tell you this. Everything that looks like darkness, as if everything was caving in, it just seemed out of the blue, just like a magic. And the Bible says everyone who asks receives. Just phone calls. Just people seeking me out. See, I stand here today as an evidence of the fact that we as a body can never be the same again. And while we were just praising, all I could do was just cry. Because I literally had given up on myself as well. However, everybody around me didn't know I'd given up on myself. But man, I want to thank you for the word, for your obedience to the word, God. It's not possible